Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with unit 4, that is precious water. This unit talks about water. It tells us all about water. So in this unit we are going to learn about water. As you know, water is the much needed resource on the earth, and it is diminishing or depleting fast. Large areas of water is drying up, and billions of people do not have access to safe drinking water. So whatever water they drink, it is not safe for them. They do not have access for safe drinking water. Now in your book, a bar diagram is given. So let us study that bar diagram and see what is given in it. So the first bar is about total global water. In that, 2.5% of water is fresh water, 0.9% is saline water, and 96.5% is ocean water. Second bar shows fresh water. How much is the fresh water? 2.5%. So in that 2.5%, how the water is distributed? See, surface and other fresh water is 1.2%. Then groundwater is 30.1%, glaciers and ice caps 68.7%. So the third bar shows the surface water and other fresh waters. So in that, atmosphere 3.0, living things 0.26%, rivers 0.49%, swamps, marshes 2.6%, soil moisture 3.8%, ground ice and permafrost 69.0%. This way water is divided on this earth. So below there are certain questions which you need to answer with the help of this bar diagram. So let us see the first question. What is the percentage of earth's water in fresh potable water? So how much percent of earth's water is fresh potable water? As given, it is 2.5%. The second question is, what percentage of the potable water is easily available to sustain life? So what percent of potable water is easily available? So see the diagram. It is 1.2%. 1.2% of potable water is easily available. The third question is, where is the rest of the fresh water to be found? So the rest of fresh water is to be found in the glaciers, ice caps, and underground water. Next question, what does the bar on the right show? The bar on the right shows surface water and other fresh water. Next, from where do humans get most of the water to satisfy their needs? What percentage of fresh water is that? So humans get most of the water from fresh water to satisfy their needs. The percentage of fresh water is 0.26%. The next last question, what do you feel about water consumption and wastage after studying this diagram? So what do you feel? This question you have to write on your own. That is your opinion, what you feel about it. Okay? So now, let's start with section A, the lake that flew away. See the name of the lesson, the title of the lesson, the lake that flew away. It is interesting, isn't it? After reading the lesson, you will understand why this lesson has this title. So let's begin with the lesson. In that lesson, you have a warm-up activity. In warm-up activity, there are two quotes and you have to read those two quotes. Let's read it. If you throw a boomerang, be ready to duck. And the second quote is, my attitude will always be based on how you treat me. Now, boomerang. Boomerang means what? It is a curved shape, flat piece of wood. So the shape is like this. So curved shape, flat piece of wood, which is to be thrown. Especially it is used for hunting. Okay. So now here, in these two quotes, what is the similarity? The similarity is that whatever we do, we get back. The common link between these two quotes is every action has a reaction, and what goes around comes back around eventually. So you must have understood, as we treat others, others will treat us. If you treat the person well, the other person will treat you well. But if you misbehave with that person will also misbehave with you, isn't it? So similarly is with nature. Whatever we give to the nature, nature will give it back. If we destroy the nature will destroy us. So now let's read the lesson and understand it. Do you suppose a lake has no feelings, no sense of pride, no self-esteem? Now here, the author, the writer wants you to answer these questions. Do you suppose that the lake doesn't have any feelings? See, we human beings have feelings, isn't it? So what do you feel? The lake also has feelings? No sense of pride? It doesn't have a sense of pride? No self-esteem? What do you mean by self-esteem? Self-esteem means respect for oneself or one's abilities. We should have self-esteem. Okay? Do you think it can be untended without suffering? Untended. Untended means neglected, not taken care of, not looked after. So what do you think? Do you think that it can lie untended without suffering? So if we don't take care of it, will it lie without suffering? Won't it suffer? Its weeds run riot like unkempt hair. Now weeds. Weeds means the unwanted plants which are grown under the lake. So these weeds run riot like unkempt hair. Now riot means a large varied display of something. And they lie like unkempt hair. Unkempt, messy, untidy. So these weeds which are grown under the lake, they lie like a messy hair. See, when our hair is not combed, how it looks? It looks messy, isn't it? So these weeds also look messy. Its fishes choke beneath the autumn leaves. Now it fishes. As you know, in lake there are fishes. So these fishes choke beneath the autumn leaves. Choke means suffocate. Beneath the autumn leaves. Autumn leaves, the leaves, you know that trees shed their leaves in autumn season. So when these trees shed their leaves, they go in that lake, and due to those leaves, the fishes in the lake are choked. Its banks crumble under the feet of drinking cattle. And its bank means river bank, the lake, the bank of that lake. So its banks crumble. Crumble means break or fall apart into small fragments. So you know that cattle come to drink water near the lakes and rivers. So due to the feet of these cattle, the banks are crumbled. Okay. Next paragraph. Lake in Estonia is a vast tract of water, 100 fathoms deep in the beginning. Trees which seeded themselves around it drank its water and flourished dense and leafy. Now here we are talking about the lake. The name of that lake is Inn. Where is it? It is in Estonia. Estonia is the name of a place. It is a vast tract of water. This lake is a vast body or area of water. 100 fathoms deep. Now, this lake is 100 fathoms deep. Fathoms is a unit of measuring length. Especially to measure the depth of water, this measurement is used. 1 fathom is nearly about 1.8 meters. So this lake is nearly 100 fathoms deep. Means it is very deep lake. In the beginning, trees which seeded themselves around it drank its water and flourished dense and leafy. So in the beginning, the trees which seeded means have seeds. So the trees which had seeds, and the seeds fell on the ground, new plants grew. So these plants, they flourished on the bank of river. They drank the water from this lake. Which lake? Inn lake. So the trees around this lake drank the water of this lake and they flourished. They grew dense. So there was a dense forest around this lake. A forest grew, so did the darkness within it. And as the forest was dense, there was also darkness. If you must have visited a forest, you must have observed that there is a darkness because the trees are very dense and sunlight cannot reach. So here also, as the forest was dense, there was darkness in this forest. And soon within the darkness of the trees lurked a darkness of man. Now soon what happened? Within the darkness of these trees lurked the darkness of men. Lurked means waited in a secret place in order to do something wrong. So the people, the men, they waited in this darkness of the trees. They hid there in the darkness to do some wrong activities. Now, what does darkness of trees refer in this sentence? The darkness of trees refers to the density of forest. Look, the darkness of men. Now, what do you mean by darkness of men? So, the men who lived by the lake, they were very wicked, they were brutal. So darkness of men refers to the wickedness of men who live by that lake. Brigands and bandits made their lairs in the black entanglement of lakeside trees. Brigand is a bandit. Bandit means what? Robber. Especially one of the band of robbers in mountains or forest regions. So a band, a group of robbers, those who are in the mountain or forest region, they are called as brigands. Brigands and bandits made their lairs in the black entanglement of lakeside trees. Now, made their lairs. Lairs means a hidden place. They made a place to hide there. Entanglement, here it means place with dense growing trees. As there was a dense forest, the trees grew close together. So these robbers, these brigands had a place, they can make a place for hiding. They fished the lake for their supper and they spent long hours sprawled in drifting boats, tangling grappling hooks into the deeps. Now they fished lake. They means who here? Brigands. They fished means they did the fishing. They ate fish from that lake for their supper. And they spent long hours sprawled in drifting boats. They spent long hours sprawled. Sprawled means sit, lie or fall with one's arms and legs spread out. Means they sat in a very relaxed manner in the drifting boats. Drifting means which is slowly carried away by the current of air or water. So they used to lie down, they used to relax in the drifting boats, dangling grappling hooks into the deeps. Dangling means hanging or swinging. So they used to hang or swing grappling hook. Grappling hook, any kind of hook by which something is made safe. So they used to put a hook deep in the river and they used to make themselves safe, make their boats safe. You know that when the boat is in water and if it is not rowing, if it has to be in one place, then it is tied by a hook. So similarly, these brigands, they used to hook their boat to make it secure. For it was rumored the lake held greatest treasures from one earlier civilization. So now why these brigands came to that lake? Because there was a rumor that there is a treasure inside the lake. And to get that treasure, these brigands came to that lake in. The men did not dredge the shallows or clear the weed. The men did not dredge. Dredged means remove sand, silt or mud from the bottom of the water body. These people, they did not remove sand, silt or mud from the water body or clear the weed. They also did not clear the weeds, the unwanted plants which were grown beneath the lake, or cut back the nettles that mustered at the water side. They also did not cut the nettles. Nettles, it is a flowering plant. So they did not cut that nettles as well that mustered at the water side. Now mustered here means grow close together. So many flowering plants grew close together near the lake, and these people, they did not even clear or cut those flowering plants, those nettles. That would have been hard work, and they had forsworn hard work. So that would have been hard work. What would have been hard work? To remove the sand, silt and mud from the surface of the river, or to cut the weeds or the nettles. It was a hard work. and they had forsworn hard work, and they had forsworn means rejected. They did not want to do any type of hard work. Now see the line. And soon within the darkness of the trees lurked the darkness of men. What does this line signify? What is the significance of this line? So the people, the brigands, they came there. They used to loot the passers-by, those who were passing through that forest. They used to loot them. They used to cut their throat and throw them into that lake. So this shows the dark side of them. Okay. Now see the line, that would have been hard work and they had forsworn hard work. Now they means who here? They refers to the bandits. Now what did these bandits do to satisfy their needs and wants? To satisfy their needs and wants, the robbers would kill the passers-by and loot their money, dumping their bodies into the lake. So what light does it throw on their character? What do you know about the character of these bandits? This shows that how wicked and brutal these bandits were. Next paragraph. So why did their pockets jingle with gold and their gambling last all night? Because each time a traveler passed through the wood, a pilgrim or a merchant, they cut his throat and threw his body in the deep dark waters. Now why the pockets of these bandits were jingling with gold? Why was the noise of jingling of gold coins heard from their pockets? Because they used to kill the passerby, whether the passerby was a pilgrim or whether he was a merchant, it did not matter. They used to kill the passerby, they used to loot all their money, they used to cut the throat of that passerby and throw his body into the deep water of Eem Lake. The blood stained Lake Eem. The blood shamed Lake Eem. Red blood stained the bankside flowers and dripped from the bending grasses on the face of the lake. Now, because of this activity, because of killing the passers-by, what happened? There was a blood in the lake. The blood stained the lake. Means there were blood marks in the lake. The blood shamed the lake. Because of this, the lake felt ashamed. Because of this human behavior, the lake felt ashamed. Red blood stained the bankside flowers and dripped from the bending grasses onto the face of the lake. Now, the red blood, it stained the bankside flowers. There were many different kinds of flowers along the banks of the lake. So, this blood stained the flowers. The flowers got all red. They became red because of the blood. And dripped from the bending grasses. And this blood, it dripped. Drip means to fall in drops. From these grasses, it dripped onto the face of the lake. So that blood went, dripped into the lake. The blood soared and fouled the still waters of the lake till it shivered even on the windless day. So now what happened because of this blood? It soared and fouled the still waters. Soared means to become sore. The water became sore and it also had a foul smell because of the blood. till it shivered even on the windless day. So even on the windless day, the water was sour and it had a foul smell. So that's it for today. Thank you.